Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I want to show to you with my diagram the stump solar panel and true generator they are pattern working. My diagram is very useful for some place where don't have the electricity. I mean, with my diagram here, you can use for some place where don't have the electricity covered. You can use this diagram. In my video today, I have the true part one. I will let you know the part name I use in my diagram. Part two, I will explain to you how the working. Now I'm talking part one. Please follow me, my friends. Here is the system solar panel from here to over there. From this side to over there, generator. And in the system solar panel, I have the model here. I have the four arrays. Combine the box, disconnect, inverter, converter from the source DC to the AC. Relay number 3, contactor C. Contactor C of the solar panel system here, over there. Here is the timer 7, timer 1, starter of the generator A, the pattern of the generator A, the line, the MCCB, or you can use the breaker, the fuse, relay 1, contactor A of the generator A here. The timer 3, timer 4. Here is the transformer converter from the source AC converter to the DC. The charge control, the battery, the timer DS4DS SS. The fuse, the switch. Here is timer 5, timer 6, timer 2, the starter, generator B, and here is generator B. Here is the part, automatic turn off the generator B, the MCCB, or you can use the tracker, that's okay. The lights, the fuse, the relay number 2, the contactor B of the generator B here. The load is here is your house, your company, or your business over there. The ground here. My friends, now I'm talking part number 2. I will explain to you how the working. How the system here is working. Right now, I'm talking about this system working a day. Please follow me. Here is the system solar panel. I connect the model to model like this one. Negative to positive. Negative to positive. Negative to positive. Negative to positive. And negative to positive, and this array the same. And the output of the positive here, I connect to combine the box that side. The positive here and positive here, I connect to the combine the box from this side too. The negative. And the negative here, I connect to this side of the combiner box here. And the negative here, and negative here, I connect to this side of the combiner box here. And the ring wire here is connect to the ground. You see now on the left hand side here is the all the source from the get from the negative. And on the right hand side here, we have the all the source connect to the from the positive here, from the positive, and this side from the negative, this side get from the positive. Output from the combiner box took only two wire, positive and negative. Connect to the disconnect. Output disconnect is connect with the fuse and supply power to the inverter. Inverter is convert the source from the DC source to the AC and supply power to this way. And here's the relay number 3. Now it relay number 3, it have the power. All terminal normally open, now is closed. And all terminal normally closed, now is open. That's why this terminal is now is closed. And supply power at the terminal A number 1 here. A number 2 here, all the time I connect with the neutral. Right now, it have the magnet and make the contactor glow like that and supply power light 1 to light 1, neutral to neutral. I mean light to light, neutral to neutral and supply power to the low. Before to the low, I connect with the output of the contactor A. From the output of the contactor C, output contactor A and output contactor B here, I connect to get the line to line, neutral to neutral. After that, I connect to the glow here. Again, one more time. Output from the contactor C, output from the contactor A, and output from the contactor B here, I connect to get the line to line, neutral to neutral, and then after that I connect to the low here, and at low I connect to the ground. You see that? Then I'll go back with the system solar panel. Now your low have the power by the system solar panel here, and this terminal relay number 3 here now is closed. It supply power to the timer 7. At the timer 7 here, I set time for the 5 minutes. And it supply power to the part automatic turn off the generator A. And on all the terminal, on all the wire here, I connect to the part go to turn off the generator B. That's why you don't worry when the stump solar panel is working, the generator is working. No, this timer it will go to turn off the generator A and turn off the generator B. After 5 minutes here, terminal S and 5 is open. The part turn off the generator A here, it go back, it turn to the normal. I mean, it go back to the normal, turn back to the normal, the part here. And the part turn off the generator B, the same, it go back to the normal, it turn to the normal. That's why you don't worry, it working. And this terminal, it will glow. Relay number 3 here, it will glow. It supply power to the transformer here for supply power for the battery here. It supply for the transformer and transformer here convert the AC to the DC and connect with the fuse and connect to the charge control. Charge control is a the charge control keep the battery all the time it full. When the battery is low level, the charge control here it recharge the battery. And this terminal here now is open. That's why this timer DS4DS8 here don't have the power. That's why timer 1 and timer 2 here don't have the power too. And you don't worry, is the generator A and generator working when the stump solar panel is working. It's very, very safety. Work, I'm talking about the system here is working at night. At night, the stump solar here cannot make the power. They don't have the power. It's off. And relay number 3 here don't have the power. This terminal now still open. Output of the conductor C from the stump solar panel here don't have the power. Right now, this terminal now still open like that. This terminal still open like that. And yellow will get the power from the generator. Right now, the terminal relay number 3 here now is closed. And this terminal is closed, the battery supply power to the timer DS4DS8 here, and it will supply power to this way. That way don't have the power because this terminal is open and this terminal is closed. That's why the power, the source is it come from this way. Supply power to the timer 1. I set time for timer 1 is the 10 seconds. Go to start the start generator. Now generator A is on, it working. After 10 seconds, terminal S and 5 here is open and generator A here is on. The light on, the power will go to the fuse, go to the MCCB, sorry, go to the MCCB and go to the fuse, go to the relay number 1. All terminal right now, relay number 1 here have the power. All terminal normally open, now is closed. That's why this terminal it will close. Supply power at the terminal A1 and A2 all the time I connect with the neutral at the A2. It make the coil of the conductor A here, it have the power. It make the coil, it make the conductor it close. Supply power line to line neutral to neutral supply to the low over there. When the generator A working, the stump solar panel here it doesn't work. And this terminal relay number 1 here it close. It supply power to the timer 5 here and I set time for timer 5 here 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, terminal 8 and 6 here, it will close. Supply power for time to timer 6. I set time for timer 6 is 3 minutes. It supply power to the part to turn off the generator B. That's why when the generator A working, the stump solar panel it doesn't work and the generator B here it doesn't work too. After 3 minutes, after 3 minutes here, terminal S and 5 of the timer 6 here now it open. The part turn off the generator B here now it turn to the normal. it go back to the normal. And another terminal of the relay number one here now is closed. It supply power for the transformer. Transformer convert the source AC to the DC and supply to the field, output the field to the charge control. Charge control here keep the battery is full. And right now, generator A working along 4 hours. Because I set time here, it's 4 hours. At 4 hours, this terminal S and 5 here is open, and S and 6 of the timer DS40S S here, it will close. Power will supply to this way. Power from the battery here supply this way to the timer number 2. At the timer number 2 here, I set time it's the 10 seconds and start for the generator B here. And now generator B is on. After 10 seconds, terminal S and 5 of the timer 2 here is open. That's why you don't worry, it start again. Right now, generator B working, the power supply go to the fuse, go to the MCCB, or in here you can use the breaker. You can use the breaker. And go to the line. The light is on, and go to the field and go to this side of the contactor B. Right now, it's the relay number 2 here. It has the power. All terminal normally open, now it's closed. That's why this terminal is closed. And supply power for terminal A1, A2 all the time I connect with the neutral. And right now, the coil contactor B, it have the power, it working. The coil, it make the contactor, it glow like that. And supply power, line to line, neutral to neutral, and supply to the low. Right now, it's the generator A and generator B, it is working on the same time. And after 2 minutes, after generator B here working 2 minutes, the relay number 2 here supply power for the this terminal relay number 2 here, it close, supply power for the timer 3. I set time for timer 3, it's 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, the terminal S and 6 here is closed and supply power for timer 4. I set time for timer 4, it's 3 minutes. And supply power to the bar, turn off the generator A. And right now, generator A is off. After 3 minutes, terminal S and 5 here open. The part turn off the generator A here, it turn to the normal, go back to the normal. And this terminal relay number 2 here is closed, supply power for the transformer. Transformer convert the AC to the DC to the charge control, keep the battery it full. In this system here, right now, it get the power from the 3 source. The first get the power source from the system solar panel when the system solar is working by this terminal. The second source it get from the generator A when generator A working here. Relay number 1 here is closed. and the third source when the generator be working, and this terminal it will blow and supply power for this system. That's why this system for the charge battery here all the time it have the power. You don't worry. This one is a lot the power or the battery is low level. Don't worry that. And this system, the generator A and generator B here at night, it working like that. I mean it the system, the generator A and generator B here, it working at night. It working like this one. When generator A working, after 4 hours, generator B automatic it on. After generator B on 2 minutes, after 2 minutes, generator A is off. And generator B working along about it 4 hours. After 4 hours, generator A automatic is on. After 2 minutes, generator B is off. And it still working like that, back and forth after 4 hours. Or stay working, stay all night. And when a day, this system here is off, the generator A and generator B, it will off. Because a day, the system solar panel here, it has the power. And it will supply power to the load here. And the timer 7 here have the power, and it will go to turn off the generator A, and it will go to turn off the generator B. That's why for a day it the yellow here. For a day yellow here get the power from the system solar panel here. But at night, the yellow here get the power by the generator A and generator B. And generator A and generator B take turn working 4 hours. After generator A working 4 hours, generator B is on. And after 2 minutes, automatic generator A is off. And after 4 hours, generator A is on again. After 2 minutes, generator B is off. It back and forth like that. It working still stay all night. And a day, the system solar is working. It will turn off the generator A and generator B by the timer 7 here. My friends, why I use 2 generator? Because with my idea, I thought the system you use the 2 generator, it working, it very safety and it the long line. If you use just only 1 generator A or 1 generator B only, each generator cannot working all night. It made the generator it hot, get hot and somewhat from the somewhat of the generator A here, it get hot and it it cannot leave the long line. That's why I use from my diagram it the 2 generator. When the generator A working, generator B it take turn it off and release the hot. When generator B is on, the generator A is off and release the hot. That's why it make the generator or the part it live a long life. That's why I use the 2 generator. Now, my friends, please If you have the if you have good your idea, please comment at the end my video. And now my video today at the end. See you next time. See you next video with my English. It's just a little. Please forgive me with the my English. I'm talking the English just a little, not too much, but my diagram is very, very helpful, very, very workful. Thank you for your watching. See you next time.